Hey guys, this is Heretic, and this is part 3 of the Battle Mechanics series. In this video, we're going to focus on how technology works when you're in a battle with other players that are either on your side in the attack or on the other side, it doesn't matter. Before we get started, did you know that I have a Discord where you can ask questions and discuss the game with other players? Look in the description of this video for a link. For anyone who wants more videos and more access to this channel, you can now join as a channel VIP and get all the latest content well before it's made live, and you get priority answers to any of your questions. So in the last two videos on battle mechanics, I went over attack, health, defense, damage reduction. And while everything I presented was absolutely accurate, it assumed that you were in a solo fight against one other player. But what happens when you have a group of players? One of the things that maybe you would have thought from the last two videos is, with the nerfs that we have to attack and to health, why would players push those values really high, and why would they ever use attack type skills like Leviathan, like the artifact skill? In team attacks, the total attack, health, damage, etc. is averaged across all players before nerfing them on both sides. Each side, if you have 5 players on your side who are attacking, then those players have a shared average of the attack, damage reduction, etc. So in this video, we're actually going to dig into that and look at the math from a specific battle report I have. And we're going to stick with this one that I'm showing here. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. So let's go ahead and get started with the back line. And I'm going to start with ours. And again, this is an example of how the statistics work in a group fight. So there's no way I can go through every single detail here, but I want to give you the kind of general overview of how it works. So if I look through here, I have T13, tier 12 mages. I go down and Smoke has, you know, he has a few 13 archers. He has some mages. He has the same thing, 12 mages and archers. Now, if I go back down to Etmac, he has a few archers. He has mostly tier 13 mages, and yeah, that's mostly on offense. I'm looking at our offense here. If I look at Anvil, he's got some archers and some mages too. So we're gonna look at mages. So let's look at mages in this attack. So what I wanna do is I wanna look at the actual tech for each player. So if I go down to my attack and I'm looking at my mage attack. Oh, and I passed it. So mage attack 814.5. And then I go to Smoke and his is gonna be a lot higher, I'm sure. Mage attack 971.6. And then I'm gonna look at Etmap. His is gonna be higher than mine too. Let's see, his is 864. And then I go to Anvil and I know he is an archer player and his mage attack is 361. So what I would do is I would take the 814.5 plus 971.6 plus 864 plus 361.3, and that's gonna equal 3011.4. So now, if I take that 360 that is a soft cap for attack, and I multiply that times 4, that equals 1440. Now I can take the 3011.4, I can subtract the 1440, and that's gonna give me 1571.4. And then if I multiply the 1571.4 times 0.3, because that's everything over the cap, it would be 471.42, right? So then I take the 471, we'll just say 471, and I add it to the 1440, which would be the cap for us. That's 1911. I take the 1911, divide it by 4, and after all of the nerfs and averaging us out, the 4 players, It comes to 477.75. So now I can go here and I can look at my tier 13. I can do the math here. If I'm looking at my tier 13 mages. So for tier 13, as we saw, we'll go back here and look. If I go over to the barracks. So if I look over here at my T13 mages and I go, my attack is 301 and I multiply that times 3. I get 903 base damage before damage multipliers. My tier 12, on the other hand, will be 273 and I multiply that times 3 and I get 819 base damage. And I go down again to my 11s and it's 223 times 3 is equal to 669 base damage. So now let's calculate with our damage. I'm gonna go back over here to favorites. I'm gonna go over here to the battle report again. And I'm gonna start computing damage. Again, this is where it becomes like, it's so much. So there's so many things to go through, but just bear with me for a minute. So I'm gonna look through and I'm gonna see in my tech here, go down and I see damage boost while attacking, 68.3. I see damage versus infantry, 36.1. I see up there where I was just a minute ago, 35.9 mage damage. And then I also have mage damage versus infantry. Now you would want to do this versus cav and all of that. We're just going to focus right now on infantry because the enemy actually in this fight, their front line that they do have is mostly infantry. So I'm looking at that. So I take those together and I add them up and it comes to 145.1. So now I'll go down to smoke. I do the same thing again. And you know, I add those same numbers together, which is gonna be 99.8. Oh, I can show you here. It's gonna be 99.8. And then 29.9 and 7% down here, mage versus infantry. And then again, his mage damage itself is 58.1. So I add all those together and he gets 194.8. I do the same thing for Epmac here and he's gonna come out to 190.9. And Anvil, same thing, gonna do the same thing on mage because that's what we're looking at. And he comes out to 58.1. So now I take those four damages, like I add all of those together, and I come up, so I do the 145.1 plus the 194.8, the 190.9, and the 58.1, and I come up to 588.9. I take that 588.9 and I divide it by four because there's four of us. That comes up to 147.225. Just like we did on the attack earlier, that 140, so it's 147% of your attack. So that's gonna be 1.47225 times your attack. So that's how you would do that. But then, you know, I'm here and I'm looking through the enemy. And so again, that's how I would come up with the overall attack there. And that's a really important number to get to. And then you take that number and you compare it to their health score, and that'll tell you how many of their troops you can kill over in a single round, basically. Like, how many of their troops, like how long does it take to actually kill their troops? Because that's where it becomes important. But as I'm looking through the enemy here, I'm noticing, you know, they don't have a lot of frontline. This guy's got 22.2 thousand. The next one, you know, it's kind of the same. It's 6,000, 15,000. It's all really, really heavy backline. Same thing. I go over here. This guy's got, you know, he's got basically no frontline. He's got 1,000. This one's got 4,000. I mean, almost nothing. There's no frontline. So what do you think's going to happen in a battle like this? You can look over here at, you know, the battle results at the very top. Scroll, 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 scroll to the top. And you can see we lost 60,000 and they lost 1.2 million. A lot of that's going to be because, I mean, they had a lot more troops than us. They had a million more troops than us, but they had no front line. That's going to make it a whole lot easier. So they also, when I look here on the defenders, they're in, you know, it may be that, and I can't really tell here, it may be that this is a second march. It would seem like it like that. This is from a Fortress Wars. It could be their second or third march. Maybe their main march is already out. But when I look through, their tech overall isn't that high. So you combine not having very high damage reduction, which is super important, and you combine that with not having a lot of frontline, and that's going to be a huge recipe for disaster. And so I use this as an illustration here, and we'll actually look, because I'm not even looking at this, the video here, and I can already tell what happens. I mean, they've got 400, 500, 600,000 frontline, and there it's gone. So what happens is, this is, we'll get into marches in another video, but marches of your team and their relative strength matter a lot. I would argue that they matter even more than technology. So what happens in this fight, and even we don't even have to watch the replay to know what's going to happen. Once you look at what they're bringing to the march, you see that the front line dies in the very first few rounds of the battle. Because remember, when these battles happen, imagine lines, lots of parallel lines. And each one of those lines is one attack. That line's gonna include your odd and your even, cav, infantry, mages, whatever you have, right? Whatever you have and whatever your enemy has. And they're gonna fight each other. And there's going to be one row fighting each other. Then when that battle's over, then the next row is going to come. And the next row. And it happens super fast. And you're not going to see that in the replay. The replay that you see is just an illustration of what's happening. So we can tell, and we saw it actually in the replay, is that that front line dies in the very first few rounds of the fight. Once this happens, not only do our cav and our infantry just run loose to their back line, and I'll show this again while I talk, but the mages and archers are able to move up and then attack their back line as well. And it's over. It is over really fast. You can see, and you know, they have a few cav left over here, but it's not going to help them a lot. Our mages, which is the bulk of our fight, moved up. Our cav are still super strong, and they're just ripping through them. And there's nothing that they can do at that point, because they didn't bring enough frontline, as well as their tech wasn't high enough to support having a small number of frontline. So you either have extremely high tech over your opponent, or you need to bring more frontline in team attacks. So think of it this way. So if Smoke is alone and he's able to, you know, with, because he's not dividing up his tech and he's the strongest, right? So he's not, we say no one go with him. You go on your own because we don't want to water down your tech. And he goes out and he has 100,000 frontline, and the enemy has 1 million. He's gonna tear them up too, right? He's gonna kill a lot of them. But Smoke, to get through, if Smoke is able to kill 50,000 or 50,000 enemy frontline, and each one of those rounds that happen really quick, and the enemy can kill only 10, so he's 5 times stronger than them. If they bring 1 million frontline, Smoke is gonna take 20 rounds to be able to kill off their front line, and they're only gonna have to take 10 rounds. So they've made it through his front line and they're able to get through and beat him. And this happens, right? If Smoke goes out alone and the enemy has a ton of front line, he's gonna kill a lot of them, but he's gonna lose the battle, right? Just because of the advantage of having a lot of front line. But then what if a few players join Smoke, and now instead of having 100K, he has 800K frontline. And instead of killing 50K of the enemy each round, because now his tech's going to be shared with the other players and it's going to lower that average, now he can kill 25, or they can kill 25K of the enemy each round. But now they have 800k frontline and the enemy has a million. So now it's going to take 40 rounds to be able to kill them because of the lower tech. But the enemy now would take 80 rounds with the same killing 10k each round. It's going to take them 80 rounds to get through. So now Smoke's team, his side, has the advantage, even though his tech, the overall tech of the group, is lower than it would have been if Smoke would have gone alone. So the fact that they have more troops and more frontline makes up for the fact that their tech is lower. In the next video, I'm actually going to go over formations and how they work and how you should set up for both a team fight and for solo fights and how you should be thinking about them. And after that, in another video after that, I'm going to go through some of the better special skills that you can get within the game, like Garden of the Sky, Beast Skins, Totems, Elder Titans, etc., 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 and which ones I think are the best and why, and how hard it is to get them. And with that, thanks for watching this far, and as always, take care.